11 Houston, you're good at 1 minute.
Every month, the sun rises over the lunar landscape. It rises over ancient craters. It rises over vast plains of solidified lava sprinkled with moon dust. But it also rises over 12 sets of footprints. Footprints that were left there between 1969 and 1972. 12 people who walked upon the surface of the moon, only a few of which are with us today. This book is the inside story on those first two sets of footprints made by Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin on the Apollo 11 mission almost 50 years ago. When the Soviet Union launched Sputnik in 1957, the whole game changed. America was shocked by Sputnik 1. They hadn't expected the Russians to be so advanced. They had to catch up. So this is the story of that great achievement, of how Neil Armstrong was chosen to be the astronaut to place the first footprint on the moon. It was decided at the last minute that Apollo 11 would be the landing. And the story goes that Armstrong was in the toilet washing his hands, and his boss came in and said, "We've determined that Apollo 11 is going to make the first landing attempt, and would like you to command the mission." Armstrong paused for a minute, dried his hands, and said, "Okay." The problem was, who steps on the surface of the moon first? Buzz Aldrin made the case that when a ship comes to port, it's the first officer who walks onto the new land, onto the shore, and therefore, it should be Buzz. NASA eventually decided it should be Neil Armstrong, and Aldrin, ever since then, seems to have been more resentful that he was the second person on the moon than grateful he landed on the moon at all. We talked to the astronauts, we talked to the flight controllers, the families, the assistants, the politicians, the administrators of NASA. And fortunately, I've been able to talk to a lot of these people over 35 years. And it brought me, if you like, a way of seeing this mission from the inside, from the personal, from the experience of the crew, but also a sense of perspective, because this was history. This is my take on the best quotes, the best line through this remarkable story, to tell the story of Apollo 11, the first landing on the moon.